games and codes, jitway.com is the place for you. Link is also in the description.
Just like that, Obi puts it in. 1, 2, 3, he makes it quick and easy.
Fantastic goal, really it was.
There's the slide throw. Oh, he's got a man through a goal here. It's a stunning goal from Obi.
What's going on, everyone? My name is Obi and welcome to a new FIFA 18 video. So many of you asked me to review the best formations in the game in FIFA 18. And we're gonna start this mini-series with Real Madrid. We've got also some other incredible squads, guys. FC Barcelona, Bayern München, Manchester United, PSG, City. So many great squads in the game. Juventus, Torino. Make sure to leave a like if you want to see also that those formations being reviewed on the channel. So we've got Real Madrid now, guys. You can see on the screen right now the formation that I picked for Madrid. It is a 4-1-2-1-2 narrow, and this is the formation that suits the player that Madrid has. Navas as a goalkeeper, Ramos, Varane, centre-backs, Marcelo, left-back, Carvajal, right-back, Casemiro, CDM, Asensio, left-central midfielder, Modric, right-central midfielder, Benzema, central-attacking midfielder, Bale, left-striker, Ronaldo, right-striker. Regarding player instructions, stay back while attacking for both fullbacks, stay back while attacking for Casemiro, and get in behind for both Bale and Cristiano Ronaldo. Let's talk now a bit about how you need to play with Real Madrid. You can also go for a 4-3-3 and have Ronaldo and Bale as wingers and Benzema as a striker. But in my opinion, Madrid has such quality in attack that you don't want to waste Ronaldo and Bale on the wings. This is why I went with this formation. Also, Benzema as a central attacking midfielder, he's got the finesse shot trait, so he will be deadly from outside the penalty box. And also when he goes in the penalty box, Karim Benzema is a clinical finisher with the left or with the right. 4-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot. He is best suited for a central attacking midfielder position than for a striker, because in FIFA 18 he is not as pacey as he was in FIFA 17. Casemiro, the CDM. He is big, strong, powerful, great defensive stats, great physical stats. That's where you need to use him. Let's see now our two midfielders, guys, and here I went with the left-footed player on the left side of our midfield, right-footed player on the right side, Modric, of course, on the right side. He is better in attack than he is in defense. He's a great passer. He's very agile with the ball, not bad at long shots and finishing. In defense, he lacks a bit the physical part of the game. That's a downside. Asensio, on the other hand, he's above average at almost everything. Okay, his defensive stats are not very good, but he is a more physical player, a taller player than Modric, a more stronger player than Modric. He's good at long shots, he's got 4-star skill moves, great at dribbling, very, very good at passing the ball. Our two fullbacks, Marcelo, Carvajal, not the paciest, but they are good defensively, good in attack. Carvajal a bit better than Marcelo in defense. Guys, Sergio Ramos, Varane, great, great, great center backs. Top 5, top 7 in the game, in my opinion. Last but not least, we've got Gareth Bale, Cristiano Ronaldo as strikers. Bale, so pacey, so physical, so good at finishing, and also now not bad at all at headers from crosses. Make sure to try always and finish with his left foot, guys, because with the right foot he's got only 3-star weak foot. Can be a bit shady with the weak foot at finishing, but his left foot is just stellar, guys. Cristiano Ronaldo, on the other hand, it doesn't matter left or right header. I think he can score also with his back. He is number one player in the game except icons. 5-star skill moves, 4-star weak foot, great at headers, great with the left, great with the right, fantastic at finesse shots, fantastic at power shots, fantastic at long shots, finishing, you name it, he's got it, fantastic at crossing, And that's why a player of that magnitude, a player of that value, I did not want to waste on the wing. If I play Madrid and then I put Ronaldo in the center as a striker in a 4-3-3 formation, I don't have speed on the wings. I've got Benzema, Bale or Vasquez, but Vasquez ain't that good this year. So this is how I see the best formation for Real Madrid. Leave a comment below and let me know your thoughts about it, guys. In the next minutes, you're gonna be able also to see a compilation of goals that I've scored in seasons using this formation. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Hope you'll enjoy the goals. Drop a like. Let's try and get over 1500. That would be awesome and much appreciated. Thank you all for watching. My name is Ovi and I'll see you guys later.
probably been since you told me so.